these are the Oppo Enco Air 3 Pros. Now, before buying these, I saw a lot of YouTube reviews and everybody was praising about how good they sound and how Oppo is offering this magical, extremely good sounding earbud at such a low price. And now that I have them, and they're fine, you know what? They're fine. They're not bad, but they're not good either. They're definitely not as good as all of these reviews were saying. Here's the full review. So first up, let's talk about how they look. They look fine. They have a nice green box, which is a unique color. The top of the case or the lid is transparent and has this ridge kind of a design. It's a different look. It kind of glows when you put it up against a light source. I think they're trying to form a sort of a bamboo kind of look because the drivers are made of a bamboo fiber, which is one of their main USPs. But yeah, I think they look good. The Oppo branding has a golden shimmer to it. The buds themselves look like AirPod Pros with a bit more geometrical squarish design. The side of the buds have flat touch sensitive areas, which does have touch gestures, so you can play, pause, skip, and change the noise canceling modes. You get three silicone ear tips with them, medium, small, and large. They also fit fine. I mean, just like any other earbuds with the stem. They are pretty lightweight, which is good. And the finish is also like it should be in this price. So it's glossy, but it's fine. It's not bad quality. Let's talk about the sound. All right, so these have been praised by a lot of reviewers for sounding neutral. So they don't accentuate the bass like most of these other earbud brands do, like OnePlus or Skullcandy or, you know, all of these brands, which are selling in this price sensitive region because most people equate sound quality with bass. So these don't do that, which is a new sort of zinger in this price segment because most people do. So all these audiophiles are a fan of neutral sounding earbuds because then you can hear the details in the highs, the mids, and then you also have an ample, the right amount of bass. So you get all of the audio frequencies, giving you a more fuller experience of what the artist was trying to convey through their music. Most people will not like that because most people like to listen to hip hop, to pop, and you want that bass and it sounds good, it sounds fun. It sounds more bright than having a flat sort of EQ, which these guys have. Now the bass is not bad. You also have a bass boosted mode on the app. The app is a whole separate issue that I'm gonna talk about a bit later down in the video. And you can change the EQ from natural to bass boosted and have more bass, and then the bass becomes, I'd say, average. These other companies will still have much more bass than the bass boosted mode on these. The bass boosted modes will give you average bass. It's the least amount that should have been in the normal neutral flat EQ. They have a bamboo fiber driver, which apparently gives you better sound than rubber or plastic bass drivers, which is used in most buds. These have a single driver, unlike the OnePlus Buds 3, which have two drivers, one for low frequency or the bass, and then the other one for highs and mids. So the EQ is very flat, so you do hear more of the frequency band than you would maybe in a OnePlus earbud because of that bass boosted characteristic of them. My main issue with these was the sibilance. Now, sibilance is the sharp, almost painful sensation that some people get in their ears when sounds like S and sh sort of sound is made in a song, or whenever a person says that in a video or a movie. And some people get it, some people don't. If you are more sensitive to sibilance, don't buy these. And it's almost painful sometimes, and you have to turn the volume down to the point where you can't really listen to the other stuff, but just because it's so painful, because of the sibilance, you have to turn the volume down. Now, talking about the bass, there are three modes in the app's EQ settings. There's a natural, there's a bass boosted, and there's another one I don't remember. But in the natural one, the bass is, I'd say, below average. I think I would definitely want more bass, even if your headphones have a flat EQ. In the bass boosted preset, then the bass is, I would say, average. That's where I would have liked it to be, even with a flat EQ. But when you turn it up to the bass boosted setting, then you are muddying the mids, which was the whole point of these headphones, that you should have a flat EQ and listen to the tiny details of music. These sound average. They sound fine. They're not that great as people say they are. Let's talk about the app. They use the Hey Melody app, which is the common app for all OnePlus and Oppo headphones. And the app sucks. There are only three presets to the EQ. There's also this golden sound thing where First, they will scan your ears, sort of analyzes your ear canal, and it'll tune the noise canceling according to that, and also some of the frequencies. Then these will sound a series of beeps through both the left and the right earbud, and then you're given this volume slider option to slide it down to the point where the beep just disappears. And there's like four beeps in each, so it's a 15-minute process. You do it. I tried this thing several times, and all it did was just, it boosted the highs and the mids and made it sound tinny, and the sibilance issue just worsened. I did not like the golden sound thing. Maybe if people don't have the issue of sibilance, maybe they will like it, but it just made it, the damn thing, a lot worse. I had to reset these buds entirely to get rid of the issue, because even after I turned off golden sound, the sibilance issue still persisted. After completely resetting them, which you do by touching and holding both the buds while they're in your ears, disconnected to your phone for like 15 seconds until you hear a beep, and then they get reset. So golden sound, not a fan of. The noise canceling. The noise canceling also has a personalized noise canceling option, which also made it worse. The intensity of the noise cancellation decreased when I used the personalized noise canceling option, so I turned that off as well. There's also a surround sound option called Oppo Alive Audio. And when you first try it, it does sound kind of cool that, oh yeah, I'm having a wider sound stage, and it does seem like I'm having multiple speakers around me. But soon you'll realize that it's just a forced echo and reverb put to any and every sound that comes out of your phone. So including the keyboard taps, they'll echo like you're just tapping something in a giant hall. So I turned that off as well. In fact, in the end, because of the sibilance issues and the noise canceling issues, I actually ended up deleting the app entirely and then hard resetting these by touching and holding the earbuds. And now finally, they sound fine now. So I would just say, just don't download the app. Just set them up like any other pair of Bluetooth earbuds from your Bluetooth settings, and you're good to go. Let's talk about the noise canceling. Now this is where they do really shine. The noise canceling on these buds is actually amazing for the price. They cancel out a lot of noise, especially the sort of low to mid frequency, the usual buzzing sounds of air conditioners, fans, table fans, traffic, plane sound, I guess, if you're going in a train, if you're going in a car, the buzzing of the car, the tire noise, the road noise. They do a really good job in canceling those out, especially when you turn off the personalized noise canceling setting. And they also have a transparency mode, which you can trigger by touching and holding either of the earbuds. The transparency mode is also good. There's seemingly no lag, and you can use these like an open back pair of headphones or like the non-pro AirPods. So yeah, big thumbs up on the noise canceling. They have a USB-C charging port. The battery is not the best in the business. Other buds will last longer, including the charging case and the earbuds. No wireless charging. They also have dual device pairings, so you can connect them to two devices at the same time. You have to do this through the Hey Melody app, which sucks, but that's how you do it. You can open that section on the app, and then you can connect them to two devices. They will play audio from either of those whenever you play audio on either of those devices. They did not automatically pause audio on one device if I was trying to play audio from another device, which is kind of sad. You have to manually pause them and play them. Now, I was using an iPhone and a MacBook, so maybe they work better with Android devices. They do have in-ear detection, which also works brilliantly well. These are an average sounding pair of earbuds with great noise cancellation, a fairly good looking build with multi-point connection, 5 out of 10 sounding pair of earbuds. Don't expect anything crazy.